Hello to the English-speaking world and beyond. In this video, I would like to appeal to and would like for us all to learn from the United States of America, a country in which set the standards of a secular government which cannot be dictated to as to how it proceeds by any religion, cleric, or whatever you wish to muster yourself as. The separation of church from state is paraphrased from Thomas Jefferson in a way of breaking down the meaning of the Establishment Clause and Free Exercise Clause of the First Amendment to the Constitution of the United States, which reads, "Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof," meaning no religion shall dictate law, but no one will be deprived of their rights to exercise their religion. And the second part may not have been passed in today's society had we known how problematic it was going to get. It derived from when the state was being formed. If you was a Protestant, you couldn't be a governor in one state. If you was a Catholic, you couldn't do X, Y, and Z in another state, and it was becoming far too problematic to get the job done and form one rounded government. This should be a clear sign to the rest of the world how to make a world function by deleting, by casting aside the mythology of each culture and instead allowing reason to take the main platform and work as a mainstream. Patronizing belief systems have only formed a take, take, take mentality from those in which offer us very much a different tone altogether. America being the most beautiful country on the planet as far as I'm concerned, the only thing they don't have out there is a sort of North Pole. But then again, I'm sure Alaska could provide a similar feeling. A country free to exercise its actual free will and free speech should not be prohibited by the defeatist mentality of those surrounding them that clung on to the first answers that they were told, not long after they had left the womb of a person following the very same list of rules. The same freedoms have caused America to have at least a 50% population which are too heavily Christian and reject evolution in schools. No secular government should allow this, and the rest of the world should take an example a secular government that doesn't allow such a thing. And I plead to you, America, to fight it wherever you can. I plead to you to preach to the rest of the world how much better your system is than those of us still affected by the church or by Islam or by any other religion's influence, in which does not have the best intentions of the population or the population's future. The fact is, the Americans are our wonderful allies. They are English-speaking people, much like our cousins around the world, and our greatest asset into the safekeeping of the West and the survival of life as we know it. Here in England, it's easy to spit venom at the rest of the world, and though I believe my history and heritage is the best I could ever ask for, I can't deny what brilliant system of law exists elsewhere. Despite America have ridiculous, whacked out, crazy laws on other issues, when it comes to this, they should uphold it and not allow the whinging in their ear or the liberal tactics of people like George W. or Obama reading from the Quran to try and dumb people down. They should not have George Bush reading from the Bible in order to dumb people down. This is a secular government, and that's exactly how the people should be treated, therefore, when it comes to political terms. You, America, are the first, and I'm hoping you won't be the last. So set the example in which some of us can preach of. People like me need to be able to turn to a country like yours. Do your best to make sure your government upholds the constitution that you have been entitled to, and to uphold the standard of living that the West has come to know. It's not too late for you as far as immigration goes, and religion has to be conquered in order for a secular society to be able to combat mythology's cultural differences, which then cause our own disenfranchised youth to defend without truly knowing the subject matter. Thank you again, United States, from England and Great Britain. This has been Mr. Heretic at Revelation Be Damned. Think for yourself.